This is my MAME cabinet, which I built some years ago. It now lives permanently here at the Hackspace. We don't accept money. Everything is free. So in order to insert coins, I just provide a button. You can have as many credits as you like. When people see it for the first time, they're always looking for the game that they played when they were kids. It's a custom carpentry cabinet that was built around a 17-inch monitor at the time. The reason why it has the all of the shape that it has, so that I could play the game Defender in as realistic a manner as possible. Inside we have an old Pentium 4. It just happens to be the most recent free PC I got hold of. MAME is an acronym for Multiple Arcade Machine Emulator. Just emulates different arcade machine hardware. They were just computers. There were quite a lot of different popular processors. Z80s, 6800s, 68000s. It's basically just a PC, and the only fancy stuff is the controls.
Can we have a look?
Well, the joysticks and buttons are just micro switches. All of the micro switches come out and come into a keyboard matrix. Whilst this one is based on a keyboard matrix breakout that I managed to get as part of my job, previous incarnations have had, I've just ripped out the keyboard matrix from a keyboard. So when you press a button on a keyboard, there's a two-dimensional matrix of contacts. You join up a row and a column. That sends a signal to a small, very small PIC, programmable interrupt controller, a PIC, which interprets that and sends out a keyboard scan code to the PC. You get a means of inputting 150 different buttons or something like that. In practice, you can't really use all of those button presses because keyboard controllers tend to think that if you press more than four buttons at once, that the cat sat on the keyboard or something like that, and it disables those keys. The various key presses that result from joystick movements come into what is broken out as a keyboard matrix here, and just goes down into the PC. I've also got an external keyboard for convenient typing of commands and what have you. These joysticks are either eight-way or four-way. If you are playing a maze-type game, say Pac-Man, you definitely don't want diagonals because they register, say, up and left at the same time, and it's entirely up to the game whether you're going to go left or up when you get to a junction. These joysticks have a built-in template that's selectable from above, which is one of the reasons why I spent the massive £50 on these joysticks, which limits the angles at which the joystick can go. It basically cuts out the corners so that you can only go up, down, left or right, and that's selected by lifting the joystick and giving it a twist. Currently it runs a version of Ubuntu, a very lightweight Ubuntu called Xubuntu, spelt with an X. Linux is free. You're free to make it do just what you want so that you retain control of your computing experience. It's not the most recent Ubuntu release. Each upgrade requires a bit more computing power. So I'm going for the low-end Ubuntu lightweight distribution. And every time I change it, there are things to fix. So I'm sticking with what I've got right now. Okay, right, so
This comes out of the drawer, very handy.
Yes, please excuse the mess. It's basically running the XFCE desktop, the cholesterol-free computing environment. I'm using a front end called Warcade, which is basically a Python front end that will give us a nice keyboard-based user interface through which we can select which game we want to play, launch the game, and it starts the MAME application for us. Hiding all the computing business, we're free to select from the different games that I happen to have. The cabinet design is based on the genuine Defender arcade machine developed by Williams in 1980. In fact, the code for this was written over a weekend in time for a trade fair. And it turned out to be one of the most popular games of the early 1980s. Defender is a strange game in that it has an up and down joystick and seven additional buttons. It does mean that I use both player one and player two controls And so, although I'm not playing very well at the moment because I'm trying to multitask, my intention is to become as good as the heroes I had when I was a teenager, who would play Defender all day in the arcade for just 10p. I only really work with stuff that I get for nothing. Stuff that would otherwise be thrown away. This is an old monitor from a railway destination indicator, and I get to pick up things like this due to my job. When we do refurbishments of railway stations, it will have displayed departures, how late your train is, that sort of thing. There's a certain amount of screen burn, which hard to see right now, but there's a, yeah.